When you think of Bohol, you think of beautiful beaches, chocolate hills, and tarsiers. But Bohol is also one of those places that is leading the charge in the new wave of tourism, which is all about sustainability.
We are now here with Councillor Aya Montero Caindec, who is also the chairman of Culture and Tourism of Panglao.
We wanted to ask, what is some of the activities that you are trying to promote regarding sustainability?
We have just approved our 5-year tourism master plan, and it includes our social cultural development anchored towards ecotourism and sustainable development. A lot of our primary and secondary tourism establishments have already been environmentally conscious. And as well as our tourists, we have to do a lot of information, education, dissemination, especially to the locals. We are gearing towards the banning of the single-use plastic. We have already propagated around 300 coral nursery beds. And in Balikasag Island, which is the world-renowned diving destination, we have already implemented our carrying capacity, which is 300 dives per day.
And that's so important. I mean, a lot of people think that there's this concept of strike while the iron is hot, and, like, you know, get as much as you can. But the real trick is making sure that that iron stays hot for a long period of time. And you can only do that by limiting the amount of tourists and divers and the impact that it has so that you can protect the area.
Sustainable developments are the key, you know, to survive. And in our households, we also have policies of water catchment, so you can filter the water and use it to maybe drink, have it potable drinking water. And then we also have a policy of backyard gardening. We promote sustainable agriculture, and so they can also be part of the development of our tourism industry, like in the supply chain.
Yes.
We encourage our tourism stakeholders to support local, support our farmers, support our local agriculture. We are planning to have a community tourism site, which will be part of our inclusive growth for the community, the out-of-school youth, the marginalized fishermen. We are really including the cultural enrichment and cultural preservation along with our tourism development.
It's so great that you're really keeping in mind the community and how to uplift the community, but doing it in a responsible and sustainable way. And of course, gradually, because if you really want people to do it long term, they need to be phased in and not have it shocked into their system.
Thank you, Ms. Aya. Thank you so much for just being such an amazing example for other LGUs.
Thank you, Mark. Thank you, Christy. It's truly an honor to be here and to share about what we are promoting in Panglao and Bohol.